Hi everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions, and welcome back to this edition of AGP Unboxed. Today we're taking a look at the Dreadfleet boxed set from Games Workshop. This is their new limited edition high seas adventure board game type item. And if you missed the actual unboxing, that episode will be linked in the video description if you happen to be on YouTube or if you happen to be on our website, www.agpminis.com. It will be the video directly below this one. Now, I went through and assembled a couple of the ships. And I assembled a somewhat complex one and a somewhat simple one. I also assembled this little teeny tiny little dirigible type item. This is one of the dwarven items. It's just a little blimp deal on a flying stand. I like the way the water's sculpted. Very, very cool stuff. But I'll set that aside and let you see the other things. Two items I assembled were the Dwarven Craft, because that's a fairly simplistic piece to assemble. It's basically three pieces. You have your base. I didn't actually assemble them with glue. I just assembled them with pressure. All right, you have your base, and then you have a left side and a middle and a right side. Let me pull the middle piece out if I can get it out. Oh, well, forget it. Middle piece is fairly well stuck in there, but I'm sure with some work I can probably pull it out. Anyway, this is a pretty nifty little piece. I like the idea of an open bottom ship. It's very, very interesting. You get the idea that either the base of the ship is sunken down in the water to where you can't see it, or I like to think of it in a different, slightly different way, where the bottom actually is open and these little like blimp type things. These could be very small submarines that could either fly up into the sky, like this one on the stand, or they could fall underneath the ship and explore the underwater area. I think that would be a cool option for the dwarves there. But anyway, very nifty, fits on the base very, very nicely, very few seams. Mold lines on these things are minimal at best. They're virtually none because of the way that they were positioned on the sprue. Like I said, there's just no real mold lines. There are some issues with the pieces fitting together. As you can see, there's a fairly large gap. I would call it large. But there's a seam between the two halves of the miniature. That can be fixed with a very small stream of plastic cement, polystyrene cement. So odds are pretty good. If you want these to look, you know, professionally done, you can see, again, there's a seam coming on the sides back there at a kind of a diagonal. You're going to have to go around each one of these ships after you finish assembling them with a small bead of polystyrene cement to make sure that the two halves look like they're one half, all right? So that will melt the plastic a little bit and then meld them back together, okay? So that is one of the few flaws that I've found in at least these two that I've assembled. For the most part, other than that, I really have no complaints. Really, really nice-looking items here. The other piece that I assembled was probably my favorite piece, which is the more arabesque piece. And again, I didn't fully assemble this, just assembled pieces of it. This piece actually would be glued to the mouth of this guy so that he's blowing into the sail right there. You've got this wonderful fire elemental over here. Let me kind of zoom in so you can see that a little bit more clearly. He's got two heads. Each one is a different skull. This one's a little bit more demonic skull. This one's more of a human-style skull. You've got this lovely air elemental, and as you can see the seam up there. That's the best assembly you can get right there. I tried so many different ways to get that thing to fit completely, and it just won't do it. So again, small fix, but it will need to be done if you're going to be using this as more of a display piece as opposed to a gaming piece. All right, very, very nice detail all over the ship. Really great detail on the water, with this nice wake in front of the ship, as if it's, you get the sense of movement and everything. It's very, very well done. I'm very pleased with this set. Really, really nice stuff. I may change my mind once I actually go in and paint everything, but for the most part, it is a very, very cool set, and I would highly recommend it. As far as a scale goes, from 1 to 10, I would probably, with the few minor flaws that I've seen so far, I would venture out on a limb here and go with a good 8.5 or 9 out of 10 for this set. It is just, it's gorgeous. All the pieces are very, very simple to put together. The mold lines are minimal. Like I said, the only problem is you've got a couple of areas where you're going to need to reattach or you're going to need to put some extra polystyrene cement to kind of get those two halves to come together. A few of the areas, I didn't mention this, I would dock a couple of points for this, like this particular flag right here, or mast, the peg that they give you is slightly large. It's too big to fit into the hole. And so what you have to do is come in and trim the peg down, or you could go and enlarge the hole, and then it will fit properly. But out of the box, it does not fit properly, at least not easily. I mean, you could get it in there, but it's an incredibly snug fit, and you would probably snap the mast in half if you were to try. But anyway, really, really great kit. Like I said, probably an 8.5, 9 out of 10. Just gorgeous. Looking forward to getting in and painting these things because they are absolutely beautiful. Anyway, that's it for today, guys. I hope you've enjoyed it. Be sure to check out the website, www.agpminis.com. God bless you all. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.